All right, so we are now testing this, the Neo with the microphone. So I have to actually use the phone microphone to record. And since this is Techtober, we got some nice leaf color here, so we'll be able to see how the leaves look with this test. So right now I have it in the spotlight mode, so the camera will pan with me. It's not going to move. It's just going to stay stationary. And this is really a test to see how well can you vlog with this camera. Now, one of the things that does make this, it's a little louder. It's loud. It's kind of loud. But also, the battery. So with this battery, I'll get about 15, 20 minutes with it. So we'll see how it goes. So the next test, I'm going to put it into the follow me, and I'm going to ride around near the trees and see how it does with that. All right, so now I got it in follow mode. I got it far and high as far as the setting. So hopefully we can see a little bit more of this cover. Does not look like it's really covered, doing too much of the cover. So you can't switch it while you're flying. I don't think. Maybe. No, you cannot switch it. So I'm going to have to land it, and then we're going to try it from far and low. Oh, yeah, that's a lot better. All right, so now we are far and low. So I've got it in far and low, and with the far and low, it's giving a nice little, at least it looks like it's doing pretty good. So we're walking the trees here. See how it does with this. Now, I'm walking it right now. And it's about a little below hip. But so it's like about thigh height as far as the height on the actual drone. But it is doing pretty good. All right, so let's stop that and see what we got. So now we are in direction track. So the drone will pan with me. So it's doing kind of like a shooting movement here. So it will track from the side. Not sure how I feel about this one. So now if I walk towards it, it will back up so I can kind of do some kind of reveal here. Now we'll come over to the side here. I think the main thing that I really like about this is being able to record. Is that dope? Is that dope? That's probably the biggest question. Because if this works, to do a tracking shot while I'm riding my one wheel would be nice. Past the big tree. Looks like it caught the big tree. All right. So we're still going here. Another big tree right here. All right. Now I'm going to walk back this way, see what it does. Going through a lot of leaves, I'll tell you that much. So I am really liking this. Like it's, if the colors are coming out, you know, halfway doable, that's pretty cool. All right, let's get on our board and see what we get here. So now I'm letting it keep running here. All right. Ah! My board cut off. it auto cuts off, so it wasn't like as user error, definitely. All right, here we go. All right, there we go. Wonder if it'll record that whole part. So now I got it in direction lock and direction track. And I'm going to ride the one wheel, see how it does with this. We're now going to try low and medium. It did not like low and far when I jumped on the one wheel. And the funny thing is that it actually stops recording once it loses the connection. All right, so it didn't like that. I got everything in the middle now. Going to see. All right, so it likes that. Throwing it in the low was probably not one of the best things to do. But throwing it into the medium, not too bad. All right, now we're going to ride in the grass here. They're not going that fast. It is keeping a pretty good track here. Let's go over this way. All right, we're still going good. That's tracking into the sun. So I'm going to cross over here. Nope. It is persistent to stay on my left here. So we got to kind of like work with it here. But I mean, I could always stop the recording and flip it around to the other side. But it's still recording pretty good. Got leaves. Jeez. So we're doing pretty good with this. All right. So now if I stay still for a bit, let's see. Still recording. It's coming up closer, closer. So overall, I like the DJI Neo. The tracking was good, although following it from either flat or low to get the scenery is best. Medium distance or far. One thing is that it starts recording as soon as it activates whatever mode it's in. And it stops a little short, so you want to make sure you give yourself leeway on both ends. As far as the mic recording, that was just using my phone microphone. It did come out a little hot, so it sounded a little distorted, but it did mute all the sounds, so there were no sounds. You couldn't hear the leaves rustling, cars going by, the actual drone itself, all that is muted out, and you could only hear the voice, which was actually kind of nice. I did have to turn it down a little bit, and inside the app, I did not see a setting where you can change that. The mode that I think I like the most would be direction track. That kind of, once it launches, it tries to stay in that general area. You don't want to go too fast, but it was able to follow me on my one wheel at a good rate. Also, follow is another good one to use for vlogging and following. And I would definitely say you might want to get 2-3 batteries, even a fly more combo with the batteries so you can continuously fly. I do have some other footage from when I was testing it. I did find that at night, twilight, let's say right after sunset, the picture does get a little grainy and there are no settings for the camera. So you can't tweak the camera in any way. It's basically what you see is what you get. The colors on a nice, bright, sunny day with lots of tree color and everything was nice. If you have any questions or anything you would like for me to test, please leave a comment and I will try to get to it. Thanks for watching this video and hit that like button for me. It does help out the channel a lot. And until next video, remember, take care of each other, peace out, and I will see you all soon.